What shall we do with the drunken sailor? What shall we do with the drunken sailor? What shall we do with the drunken sailor early in the morning?
There she is, Bill, sailing right across your shoulder blades.
You should have put her on my chest where I could get a look at her now and then. Scratch her, will you? She itches.
Your Marigold's a sweet little ship, Bill.
Good stuff in her, too. I helped lay the keel myself. Independent trading in the islands ain't what it used to be.
No. Company schooners out of Sydney gets the cream of the trade.
Meaning I can get a load of copra from Jim. Only to find the Walla Wagga Prince been in and got the last of it and sailed on his wildfire.
It was Walla Wagga brung me young Mr. Carr here. Carr's dying of a broke heart.
I was when I came here. Now I'm dying of homesickness. You see, my girl married the other fellow.
If any man steals your girl, suck him in the nose and get another one. Just like Jim here'd do to me if I should steal his Mary.
Change so, Bill. You can have anything I got. Take a brush from both.
Well, tide's coming in. We gotta go out on it. Come on, if you're sailing with me. So long, Mary. Tell Jim goodbye for me when he wakes up. We got a passenger, Mike.
Mr. Carr. Mike is mate and chief cook and supercargo and steward aboard the Marigold. We're taking Mr. Carr as far as Tapillo.
Ah, I like Tapillo. My anana is there.
Ah, you and your anana. Come on, shove up!
Yo ho, you fellow boys, get out your lazy lumps, we're heading for shore. Yo ho, you fellow boys, I'm up the rail and trim the sail to the fore. Look where you go and pay out a sounding line.
A sounding line.
Heave to and measure the depth.
We've measured our depth.
It's 14 fathoms now. And drop into 9. Find your hole, you kinky heads. You anchor, drop your anchor, heading for shore.
We're near the shore,
waves become our slaves. We make them all behave the way that we want them to. Ship ahoy! We're riders of the rolling sea. We sail the rough uncharted parts, not here within our hearts and ready to die or do. Ship ahoy!
Heave-ho! Heave-ho!
If you save your neck,
heave-ho! Heave-ho!
Every lover on deck,
yay!
Listen! You sailing men, we're coming to land again. Aye, aye.
The scum of the South Seas.
The Maori mate, she sailed pretty quick, Captain. Better hurry.
She's the only steamer stopping here for a month to come. Well, come on. We'll drop you at the dock.
That's a funny thing. You know, I had every kind of sickness except love sickness. Not that I ain't broken a lot of hearts in my time. Oh, well, once a rover, always a rover.
It'll be a long time before I look at another woman. She gave me this to remember her by. All I want now is to forget.
Hey, that looked like money.
It was once a lucky gold piece.
A gold piece? Hey, backwater, Mike! Get it!
Gee, if I wasn't feeling so bummed today, I'd have gone after it myself.
Oh, Mike'll get it. He's the best underwater man in the island. Is it good to spend?
Some people might want it.
Well, why don't you say so? Here's me without a copper in my pocket, let alone a gold piece. What is it?
A Spanish doubloon.
my good boy.
A shark.
Yeah, a female of the species.
Hello, Captain Bill. Loving kisses.
Hello, Anna. This is Mike's bad luck. Meet Mr. Carr.
He's nice. I like him. You come to stay at Mamie's hotel? We show you a good time.
Oh, Mr. Carr sailing on the Maury Maid.
You better change your mind.
See you tonight, Anna.
I don't know, Mike. Maybe I take trip on Maury Maid myself.
Come here, Mike. Time enough for that later.
What did I tell you? They're all alike.
Well, so long, Carr.
Thanks for all you've done for me, Captain Jones. I've only 10 pounds left. It'll take that to get me home. I'm afraid I can't pay you for my passage here.
Ah, forget it.
You keep the gold piece. I hope it brings you better luck than it did me.
All right, thanks.
So long.
So long. We gotta get some.
I knew a dame in this town was kind of sweet on me once. We'll look her up.
What good'll that do?
She married into a grocery store. Leave the grub to me.
Yeah, you better look out to get your throat cut. What we need's a drink. Come on, we'll try Joblin.
All right.
Gotta get a cargo of trade goods and stores if we're to keep going. The worst of it, Joblin's the only guy on the beach that sells the stuff we need.
But you don't owe him nothing, Captain. You settled with him last time we were here.
Yeah, I poked the old cheat in the nose, too. It may hurt my credit a little.
Oh, you fix him up.
Hey, how about that drink, Captain?
Stand by. I'll come out of there with a bottle of bust. Hi, Joblin. Ain't you got no greeting for your old sparring partner, Captain Jones?
Well, what do you want?
Drink. Here we are. Here's how, Joblin.
Well?
Oh, yeah. Take a look at that, Joblin. Know what it is?
Looks like gold. What do you take for it? A couple of dollars?
Oh, a couple of dollars. Why, that's a Spanish doubloon. That's the real thing. That's what pirates used to lay aboard ships and plunder towns to get. A couple of dollars. Huh.
Find it, Bill.
Under the water. Be truthful. Just off an island. Maybe a treasure island, Joblin.
Was there much treasure?
Much? Look. How much do you think a couple of kegs, chock-a-block full of those things, would be worth?
Oh, my soul. A couple of kegs. You know, I can be a great help to you in this.
You're darn right you can. I'll be back tonight.
Fine.
Hmm.
Cherie.
Hello.
What's your name?
Manana.
Manana. Nice. Nice.
You keep away from her.
Run along.
I beat you.
No, the diable.
Come on, Mike. Get up, Mike. Go ahead, get it up, Mike.
Mike, come on. Belay that, you crazy fool. Come on, Mike.
Let me go again, Captain Bill.
Here's your drink.
Pierre, I catch him with my Anana.
Anana, for that cheat you go fighting a friend of mine?
And I can let him too.
We see about that. Hey, wait a minute. This is my fight now. Hi, Pierre. How's things?
Very nice. It's good to see you again, Bill.
Yeah. It's good to see you, too. You know, of all the guys I don't like, you're the one I like most.
Get in there. Fix him up!
Well, how about it? Had enough?
Plenty. Thank you very much.
Bill!
I'm
glad to see you.
Is Monsieur Samson yet, Marvel?
Go see for yourself.
Au revoir, Bill. I see you again, eh?
Yeah, I'll keep an eye peeled.
Bill, the brandy's waiting. And Anna said you wanted to be...
Yeah, well, Anna's an optimist. Say my good luck by her.
Let's hear it.
Well, take a look.
Hey, wake up before you shoot, Monsieur Samson.
Here.
Oh, I thought they had you in the jug over at Sidney.
It is a long story, my friend. Move over and I tell you.
Gold, I'm sure it's real gold.
Betcha. You know how these buried treasure tales have been going through the islands all these years? Well, it's about time somebody found some, don't you think?
How much did you get, Bill?
Well, it's hard to say just how much this stuff is worth, but... if the people in the town got the idea I had a couple of kegs aboard my ship, huh? Of course, I haven't, really. All I've got is one little piece as a sample.
I know you, Bill. You always was lucky.
Yeah, I won't deny that. Well, I gotta go, Mame. I gotta see...
Bill, anything in the house is yours.
Oh, thanks. But remember, I'm trusting you, Mamie. Not a word of this to a soul.
Not a word, Bill. Not a word.
Well, so long.
So long, Bill.
So, here I am, my friend, badly in need of money. Suggest you get it for me. Very quick.
I'm broke.
Ah, but you can get some for me. It will be better for you.
Sam, listen, Sam.
What do you want?
I've got to talk to you, quick. It's private.
Ooh, never will I intrude upon two lovers' secrets. Don't forget what I tell you, eh? Well?
Sam, what do you think happened? That big lunkhead, Captain Bill Jones, has found a pirate treasure. Gold, Sam. He's got it aboard his boat.
A pirate treasure? Are you drunk so early? I ought to suck you one.
I tell you, I saw it, Sam.
Saw what?
Pockets full of gold. Hands full of Spanish coins. Gold, Sam. Gold. Don't you realize? Gold.
Hey. Hey, Mike. Mike.
We wait for you, Captain.
Well, I'm staying ashore. I got a date with Joblin. Where's Bert?
Here he comes. Come on.
Oh,
Don't believe a word he says, Captain.
Hi, Doc.
Hello, Bill.
Long time no see, Doc.
That's right. I was unconscious last time you made Tapillo. My old enemy here had me down.
Yeah, I heard about it. Must have been a rip snorter.
Well, it was. I was out for 3 days. I saw the Marigold coming in this morning. I've been waiting for you. Oh, Noel! Sit down, Bill. Have some breakfast.
Yes, sir.
Drop a half dozen eggs in the pan. Bring out the cold joint. And fill up the big pot of coffee.
Right away.
Here's to your appetite, Bill.
It's never failed me yet. How's yours? You look fit.
Oh, I'm about the same. I exist on this mostly. You can't teach a besotted old stomach new tricks. Tell me about yourself. Where have you been, Bill? What you been doing?
See this thing?
That's a doubloon. Where'd you steal it?
Found it.
Found it?
Yep, at the bottom of a lagoon.
Oh, you're a liar, Bill.
No, I ain't. Not much of a one.
Say, what are you up to?
Well, Doc, here's the way of it.
What's this yarn about Captain Jones and his treasure?
Treasure? I don't know anything about any treasure.
Don't lie to me, Joblin. He told Mamie he was over here talking to you.
The fool, blabbing it all over town.
How much has he got, did he say?
You would never believe it, Samson. But he brought back 2 kegs of it.
2 kegs of it, Bill?
Chock-a-block.
You're killing me, Bill. You're a calamity to these parts.
if I only had some trade goods, knives, tobacco, muskets, flash junk, I could take a swing through the islands. That is, if I had some grub.
Joblin might stake you on speculation. He's hard up for cash.
Joblin? The old pirate owns half the island.
Yes, but he's overreached himself with land.
Serves him right. He's as crooked as a sea serpent.
Here's someone who knows more about that than either of us.
Past 8 years.
Well, how'd that be?
Oh, I'll tell you sometime. Oh, please go on with your breakfast. I have to change anyway.
But hurry back.
I will.
What's the matter, Bill?
Did you see the way she looked at me?
It seemed to register.
Register? It was a bullseye. I could feel a bell ringing inside.
Captain,
not
then, this boy.
No, she's the daughter of an old friend, Captain Dodd Lewis. He was murdered and his safe broken open, everything taken, including a note for $20,000 which he'd loaned to Joblin. Madge came here to collect the money. She had nothing else. But Joblin paid off the note before Lewis' death, that it was returned to him and he destroyed it. Of course, Madge knows he's lying, but she has no proof. She had no money, no place to go, so I made her come here.
Joblin's a dirty crook.
Well, I'm almost sure of that.
I'll make him tell the truth. I'll break every rib in his chest one by one.
Oh, no. You can't do that, Bill.
Oh, please don't get up. What's the matter?
Oh, Joblin's the matter. Always has been the cheating devil.
Oh, never mind, Joblin. Go finish your breakfast. And let me congratulate you, Captain Bill. I'm so glad for you.
About what?
Why, the treasure, of course.
Who told you about the treasure?
Why, everybody's talking about it. It's all over town.
All over town? Oh, Bill.
I got it straight from Captain Bill's mate. They brought back a whole fortune in gold pieces. I know a man who saw the gold. Pieces of eight. Spanish doubloons.
Found in the bottom lagoon. Pirate's treasure.
No, it was on the Campbell Island.
How much do you suppose he got?
4 kegs for it. Running over with it.
4 kegs?
Just for it.
Did you say 10 barrels of gold?
8 barrels, nothing. 20 he's got.
The blues. The blues. Pirate's treasure. Gold?
Treasure? Gold?
Did you hear? Those guys found gold.
Oh, do I have any gold?
Gold.
Pirate gold, Mike? Gold. Gold and gold. In the cave. Big iron bound kiss, rotten and bursting with it. Jewels and pearls, scattered among dead men's bones.
That's the truth.
What beach was it, old Bellamy lad?
Never you mind. Captain Bill, he's keen as alive with that.
Tell us more about it.
Yeah, go ahead.
Come on, tell us about it.
Come on.
All right. Well, it was this way.
No, Ella. Oh, is it?
What's the matter with you girls? Haven't you got anything better to do than to talk about treasure? There's customers to wait on. Come on, get busy. And Anna, come here. You know Captain Bill's mate. What did he tell you about it?
Oh, Rick, tell me. The foreign hedge of that body's so full of gold, you're walking it up to your knees.
What a sensation. Up to your knees, eh?
So you see, the story's all a myth. There is no treasure.
It all started with this one lone doubloon.
You know, this is really a terrible disappointment to me.
I've been getting to be kind of disappointed myself.
You're one of the richest men on earth, Bill. All the money in the world couldn't buy that body of yours.
Yeah, I suppose I ought to be thankful. Trouble is, it costs so much to feed it. Well, thanks for the breakfast, Doc. Goodbye, Miss Lewis.
Goodbye.
Poor Bill. He's flat broke.
Oh, I'm sorry. You know, he's been a hero to me ever since I first saw him.
What, you met Bill before?
Remember when the steamer McCullough went ashore 8 years ago?
Of course.
I've always kept that clipping. I was on that steamer with my mother and father. Captain Bill's little schooner was the first to reach us, and he stood by in that terrible storm until everyone was saved. Oh, he was wonderful.
Bill shows up best in storms and fights.
The minute I saw him, I knew he was my Captain Bill. I wish I could help him.
You silly child. I should think you'd have trouble enough without... Well, here comes one of your troubles now. The bumptious old fool.
Shh! Have you no respect for wealth?
None whatever.
Good morning, Warren.
Morning, Doctor.
Morning, Warren.
How sweet and cool you look, Madge. Just like a jasmine in a garden.
Yes, and you smell like one, Warren.
Now, Doctor, a touch of scent doesn't know it any harm. I'd rather have it on my handkerchief than on my breath. I got him that time.
Yes. I know this Romeo of yours wants to be alone with you.
Madge, I don't think the doctor likes me.
Oh, it's just his way.
I don't care much about him either. And I don't think you should stay here in his house. People are beginning to talk.
That's ridiculous.
I'm only thinking of your own good. I've told you a dozen times how fond I am of you. Why don't you marry me? You can't go on living like this.
Have you heard of Captain Bill Jones, Mr. Warren?
Heard of him? Who hasn't?
They say he's found a great treasure somewhere.
Yes, yes, I know.
But he needs capital to go after it. Now, if you would invest, say, $1,000, without letting him know that I suggested it, why, we might talk marriage seriously.
Hey, watch out what you're doing.
The captain's breakfast.
Bill, did you ever have a list of the passengers you rescued from the McCullough?
Yeah, they sent me a frame resolution of thanks. I hung it in the galley to keep the rats out of the flour barrel.
Have you ever met any of them since? The passengers, I mean.
No, and I'm glad of it. There wasn't a good-looking gal in the bunch. I looked them all over, careful, like the same as I always do.
Yes, there's one you missed, Bill.
Which one?
You'll see.
Good morning, Bill.
Hi, Joblin.
Don't you think we could go below and have a little conversation, sort of private-like?
We're fumigating below to keep out the rats.
But you'll have to have stores, Bill. You know, you can have anything we've got.
Well, that's fair enough.
All you've got to do is leave a couple of doubloons, a couple of bags of doubloons in my safe for security, and then
security.
You can...
Security? Oh, I'm surprised at you, Joblin. That hurts coming from you.
But Bill, business is business.
Security.
Our visitors, Captain. Pretty lady this time.
But Bill, listen.
You're a great disappointment to me, Joblin. Great disappointment.
Oh.
Hello, Captain Bill. May we come aboard?
Well, hello, Miss Lewis. I'm glad to see you. Well, you come over the side like a sailor, miss.
At least a sailor's daughter. And you've helped me over the side once before.
When was I that lucky?
It was on the McCullough.
You?
I
thought you said there were no good-looking women on the McCullough, Bill.
Suffering mackerel.
Oh, you better help Mr. Warren aboard. He's no sailor.
With that old goonie in the boat, who is he?
Shh. He's one of the richest planters on the island.
What's he want?
He wants to talk to you. Be nice to him, Bill. Come aboard, Mr. Warren.
It's about time somebody thought that. Careful, will you? You don't need to tear my arm out of its socket.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you had some meat on those bones.
Oh, Captain Bill Jones, Mr. Guy Warren.
How do you do, Captain?
First, I want to see your ship.
She ain't exactly a boudoir below deck.
Never mind. I grew up at sea on my father's schooner.
I'll show you about. If you go for it, hold your nose.
Oh, I know. We carried copper, too. I don't mind it. Come on, Doctor.
Charming girl. What, Captain?
Yeah.
Can you blame me for loving her?
Loving her, you?
Yes. She wants me to invest $1,000 in your next treasure voyage.
The devil she does.
Yes. If I do, she'll marry me. Now, if you let her think that I have invested $1,000, I'll make you a little present of, say, $100. Easy money, Captain.
And she gets a fuzzy old granddad for a husband, eh? You and your rotten $100. Listen, you old walrus. You know where the devil lives?
Of course I do.
Well, go there, then.
What?
Blast
my
your eyes.
Come on. Red, come here, quick.
Goodbye.
Madge.
I hope you choke.
I'll teach you a lesson. You can't...
I should have dropped him over the side.
You show you.
I hoped you'd accept his offer, but I'm kind of glad you didn't.
Did you know she was thinking of marrying that fuzzy old lobscouse?
Yeah.
Well, why don't you do something about it?
What could I do?
If you're a doctor, you could poison the old buzzard.
Yes, I might at that. But the poor child would only be that much worse off.
Why don't you marry her yourself?
Do you think she deserves that? Besides, she was engaged to a boy. Well, they had some sort of misunderstanding.
He must have been a dumb fool. Who is he?
Well, a young trader by the name of Mackenzie.
Old Walla Walla Burns made in the wildfire?
That's the lad. He's a good sort, isn't he?
He's the best, but he needs a going over, giving up a gal like that.
Bill, she's licked. If anything should happen to me, her only way out would be to the altar with old man Warren.
I'll carry her off the sea before I'll let her do that.
Make a pirate queen of her, eh?
No, but we'll sail until we find a wildfire, and young Mac will marry her, or I'll break his blasted neck.
You can't sail, Bill. Where's the money to come from?
Oh, yeah, that's it. The money.
Skip.
What the devil? What's this?
$20. Bert, Skip, I didn't steal that money. A fella gave it to me to put some stuff in your coffee.
Yeah? What kind of stuff?
Something to put you to sleep.
Mm-hmm.
And then he and his mates are coming aboard to find our treasure. Then he's going to give me $100 more. Nice guy.
Oh, swell guy, yeah. When's all this going to happen?
Well, he says pretty soon now. He came out to see me today just to find out how smart I am. By golly, I must be smart. We need grub.
Why, you cheating, scheming devil, swindling a trusting businessman out of his investment. Huh? Wonder who's behind this. There's nobody off the beach. Nobody on the beach has got $20. Bert, this thing's going to run into money. Big money. That doubloon wasn't so unlucky after all.
And your good luck, Captain. I'm the ship's mascot.
The roaring waves become our slaves, Wilbur.
Ahoy, Bill!
Ahoy! Ahoy there! Hello there!
Hello, Bill. I don't know how to thank you, but the doctor told me what you said, and I'm sailing with you when you leave the pier.
Well, wait a minute. I've been thinking. A girl like you alone on a schooner with a guy like me? Maybe we ought to have a chaperone.
That's right, you should.
Why don't you come along?
Sure, Doc. Everybody knows you're on the level.
The voyage would do you good.
Not a bad idea. I'd like to get away at that.
Then it's settled. How soon do we sail?
Well, if I can raise some money in a day or two, we'll put to sea. And another thing, as soon as we overhaul the wildfire, you're going to marry young Mackenzie. Do you get that?
I get it, Bill.
Well, what's the matter? You love him, don't you?
You're no sweetheart.
Well, I'm glad that's settled. So long, Bill.
So long, Doc.
Bye.
Hey, Captain.
What?
Hey, Skip, come here. Come here. That fella that gave me the money, he came aboard to see me while you was out fixing the gym. He said that tonight's the night and to put that stuff in your coffee. Here's the stuff.
Did you get any more money out of him?
More money? No, but he said tonight...
You don't understand the business of being a proper crook. A crook promises and gets paid. Then he backs down and gets more pay. He had the money to give you, all right, but you didn't have sense enough to ask for it. I ought to take it out of your wages. If you ever get any wages.
Look, and then after you're knocked out with the stuff, I'm supposed to show a light in the taffrail. Then he comes out in a boat with some gin for the crew. Nice guy.
And there'll be a powder in the gin.
Oh, sure, but I don't know that. And then when the crew gets good and drunk, he and his mates come aboard and get the gold.
And you get knocked in the head.
Oh, sure, he's a nice guy.
You know, the fella behind this rig out would be a pretty smart guy if he wasn't such a fool about treasure.
My biscuits are burning.
Dead to the world. It worked all right.
Oh, that's fine, fine. Take a look at the rest of the crew.
Yeah. Oh, blasted sense and acting like we was afraid of them. They won't wake up. Look. See him land down there? The big lug.
And that gives us the whole night to work in. We'll tear this tub's ribs from the keel till we find it.
It'll be below decks. Have you got your tools, Chips?
Yeah, I got them right here.
Come on, come on, let's go.
Ah, I'd like to crack him over the head.
You ain't going to. Hire a gold as any man's as can get it. But no hitting of a man what's been drugged.
Look here. He's been tampering with a bulkhead here.
Most natural it'd be hitting that where he could keep an eye on it.
Tear it out.
Right.
Smash it in.
It's coming.
Smash! You're looking in the wrong place, mate. Mike! Mike! Come here, Mike. You take it.
Aboard to steal my treasure, eh?
Joblin.
So you're the guy behind this, eh? I suppose you know it means prison for all three of you.
It was a gamble, Bill. Just looking for your treasure? I lost him. I'll pay.
You bet you'll pay. You'll sweat the bilge out of your filthy hide on a rock pile.
Oh, no. No, Bill. Listen. You've got to have stores. I'll bring everything you need on board and... You just make out a list and I'll take them ashore.
Ashore? Ha, ha, ha. You get ashore once and you'd call me a liar. You'd say you weren't even on my ship.
Can I give him a shave, Captain?
Captain,
Let me put some of that stuff he sent for you in a cup of coffee and give him a nice drink, huh?
Right. We'll pour it down his throat and we have to knock his teeth out.
No, Bill. You wouldn't do that.
Then do I get an order for all my stores, all I need? Do you stay here locked up until they're all aboard?
Yes, Bill. Anything you say.
Well, let this be a lesson to you. Trying to steal my treasure, eh?
I'm waiting for a hatful of wind. It'll come with a tide at 8 bells. Then we'll up anchor and sail.
But Mike's still ashore, isn't he?
Yes, he's saying goodbye to his girl. Oh, he'll be aboard in time, all right.
I've never seen it quite so calm here at night. You're so lovely. Oh, I'm so glad to be aboard your ship. I'm happy, Bill.
Good. So am I.
Careful. You know, they say only one woman aboard a ship is bad luck.
Yes, I've seen that work out, too, but it all depends on the woman. You're good luck for me. Nothing can go wrong now.
Captain Bill!
I saw someone swimming toward the ship.
That's an Anna.
Well, take it easy, Anna. What's happened?
It's my Captain Bill. You go quick. They kill him.
What do you mean? Who's going to kill him?
Samson and Mamie. To make him tell where Treasure Island is. Samson said he's going to kill Mike if he don't tell.
One of you boys, into the boat. Lively now. I'm going ashore.
Look out, but it may be a trap.
And it may not be a trap. If they've hurt Mike, I'll tear the place down around their ears.
All right, I'm going with you then.
Well, suit yourself. Here, take care of her, Madge.
Well, come below and I'll get you some dry clothes.
Gee, if I was a well man, Skipper, I'd go with you.
You fellow boy, keep guard that I know what aboard like. Get back.
Yeah.
There, this will cover you up till we get something better.
Oh, this is pretty. I guess I look too nice to be good, huh?
Oh, I wouldn't say that.
I know this will kill me, but I'm going to help the captain.
And Anna's busy serving a private party. Let me have
Mike. Hold on, where's Mike? Where have you got him?
I don't know.
Come on, spit it out.
I tell you, I don't know anything about it.
Come on, tell me where he is. Here we go, Brad.
This was last, Bill. Look out now. Nope. Mike!
I've cut and burned the poor devil till he's nothing but raw meat.
Who did this to you, Mike? Huh? Who did it to you?
That man, Samson. Mamie, she helped too. They tortured me. They wanted me to tell where is Treasure Island. I no can tell that. I don't know.
Come on, let's get out of here, Doc.
All right, Bill.
And listen to me. I'm taking this man back to my ship if I have to burn down the joint.
Yeah. Give him a chance to tell you what happened here.
You can see what's happened. That kid there that he's got was hiding away from him in one of my rooms. Oh, look, he's almost murdered the poor devil.
Come on. Okay, Mamie, you asked for it.
Here, take him, Doc.
Okay.
Gee, if I only had my health.
Come on down, you sorry.
Here it comes.
Lady of course for Quica.
Save your neck.
Heave-ho, heave-ho.
Every lover on deck.
Yay.
Listen, all you sailing men. We're coming to land. Aye, aye,
Lollapalooza's thinking about me now.
Miss Lewis?
Tim, I told you, she's going to marry young Mac. Lollapalooza Burns, mate.
That's a great mistake. He's the proper man for you. And Bill, don't forget to show her that painting I hung.
What painting? What have you been keeping from me?
Oh, it's nothing. It's...
Let me see. Why, it's the moonlight.
Pretty soon it'll be you and young Mackenzie in the moonlight, won't it?
Oh, I've never seen such fine tattooing. It looks like it's right under your skin. Only one thing.
What's that?
A picture of you and me.
Something new to me. Tell me why I feel a thrill at your side. My heart stands still in the night with you.
Is it the wildfire, Captain?
I can't make out a rig. She's acting mighty strange, lying broadside in the channel like that. Looks as though somebody had the idea of keeping us from going out. By golly, it's Joblin's schooner, the Maluka.
I can see him playing now. Black Pierre's got her. He's putting off with a boatload of our men. Visitors coming. Issue rifles, Mike.
Are you sure it's Joblin's Maluka?
Huh? Yes. And he's armed with a crew of at least 20 men.
Do you suppose it means trouble for us?
Can't tell yet. What they're in here for, only the devil knows. But you can bet it's for no good. If I didn't have the girls, wouldn't they blast me if I wouldn't be glad to see Pierre? I've licked him before, and I can lick him again.
And with 20 men in his crew?
20 or 100. He'd give me a fair fight.
But what about Joblin?
Joblin, I ain't so sure. He's up to devil with that one.
Thank you.
Captain Veal. I come for visit.
You're coming aboard alone, Pierre.
What? You afraid of me?
Yeah, I'm afraid I'll have to waste good canvas to give you a proper burial. Mike, have the men keep an eye peeled. If another boat from the schooner heads this way, we sink this one.
Right, Captain.
Ladies aboard, eh? This is a pleasure cruise, Bill?
Yeah, come on, stow that and keep your eyes off the ladies. Why'd you anchor out there in the channel?
It was proper depth. I think it's best to be safe.
You see that gaff? If you think you're going to stop me when I'm ready to go, try it. I'll hang up there to dry. Joblin on the Maluka?
I swear on my honor to say he was not. Neither he nor his friend Samson. I was sent to the man to surrender, Bill.
Friend, speak up, why don't you? You got your face hidden, but I can smell you like a month-old beached whale.
Bill, if you surrender, I promise you that no harm will come to you and your people. We know you got that gold on board.
Yeah? Just come aboard any time you like and try and find it.
Oh, you...
Yeah, you can carve him another time, Mike, and save his gizzard for me. Get back to your job. And then get below. Hey, you work fast, don't you?
The girl, she's an old friend.
Yeah, I know, but keep clear or Mike will whittle your ears off.
I didn't come here to fight you, Bill. I'm their navigator only.
Now, I'd believe you quicker than any other liar I know, but that won't keep me from cracking your skull if you start anything. Now, get the places off my ship.
Hey, come and get me before these fellow wins me over completely. I do, Bill, and good luck.
Well, the odds are 3-1. 20 of them against 6 of us.
Look here, don't count me out, Bill. I can handle a rifle.
So can I.
Well, they may try it tonight, but we'll be ready for them.
Hey, Skip, I don't feel so good, but if there's any trouble, you can count on me.
Watch with the boys.
Well, tonight.
Tonight.
Captain Bill. Captain Bill, she's gone. She's gone.
Who's gone?
Anana. She's not in her cabin. I look all over ship, but I cannot find her.
So that's what Pierre was up to.
You mean she go back to him? Oh, no, Captain. Only last night she tell me she loves me.
Well, it looks like it, Mike, old son. She swum off to more than one ship.
Anana, I knew you'd come.
We're going together, Mike, you and me and the boys. And we're waiting until the morning.
All right, Captain.
Hi, Marigold! Captain Bill! Help!
Here, here, how can I?
Come on, fellow boy, help me.
Give me a hand.
That was a tough swim, head like you are. Come on, speak up, man. That's what you came for, ain't it?
Anana come to see me. But Samson took her away. He tried to make her tell for you hide treasure. He wouldn't believe that she didn't know. So he beat her till she died. I fight for her. But Samson finished me. Poor little Anana. Served me right.
You're getting off easy, Pierre.
As soon as they sober up their men, they come to attack you. Get ready, Bill.
We'll do better than that. We'll beat them to it. Do what you can for them, Doc.
Yes.
Into the boat, Mike. 20 rounds each man.
I need to pay you.
I'm leaving Doc and you in charge to hold the deck. One way or another, I won't be gone long. How about it?
You know best, Bill.
You're not afraid?
No, I'm not afraid. I'm scared. I'm anxious, but I'm not afraid.
Don't ever tell young Mac I did that with you.
I'll never tell him.
Well, Doc, I guess it's up to you.
Of course.
Have a nice day for it, Bill.
Yeah? Smells a little like rain. Now, where's your rifle, Burp?
Oh, I'm a sick man, Captain, and I'm afraid of guns, so I'm taking this.
Say, you're sleeping on what?
It's all right, Doctor. Go right on. Right on.
Come on, you. Come on. Get him over there. Come on, you.
Aha, Samson.
And you.
Oh, blast you, Mike. We can't spare him, not yet.
You haven't won yet, Jones. Joblin is aboard your schooner now, killing every soul you left aboard.
Mike, come with me. Burp, you stay here and watch these guys. If we don't come back, you'll know what to do with them. Come on, Mike. Burp.
They're in there. Come on out. All right, break it down.
Be careful, Doctor.
Yeah, good boy, Pierre.
I'll be all right. Get me that lid, quick. Break it down.
What can I do, Doctor?
Nothing, my dear.
They'll rush us any minute. They're probably ready for us right now.
Let them come.
But what can we do? Two wounded men and a girl.
You give me the gun. Stay back. Here they come.
Don't kill me, Bill. I give up. I surrender.
Didn't you hear him, Captain?
No.
He'll cheat. He'll hang. There's £1,000 reward for the murder of Captain Lewis.
No. I didn't do it. I didn't kill him. It was Samson. I swear it, Bill.
Come on. Get him below. Ahoy!
Ahoy, Doc. I knew you'd be back. You're Calamity, Bill.
Can't we do something?
No, my dear. I'm in luck. Better this way than by the alcohol route. Good sailing. You too.
It's the wildfire, Mike. Where's Captain Bill?
Below. With Samson.
You better run up the distress signal. We'll need help. Then call the captain.
You're going to keep me tied up like this?
You're too valuable to lose, Samson. Joblin just confessed that you murdered Captain Lewis.
Now, Joblin paid me to do it. To get his note for $20,000 out of the captain's safe. But I didn't give him his note. I told him I burned it.
And you didn't burn it, eh? Maybe you got it on you right now.
Why, you blessed?
Let's just have a look. Miss Lewis needs that paper in order to collect from Joblin's estate. Let's see what you've got here. Now, that looks like it. By golly, it is it! I'm keeping you tied up and locked in, Samson. I don't want Mike to cheat the hangman.
Oh, Madge, you see that schooner hove to over there? It's the Wildfire.
Look, they're putting off a boat. Walla Wog will be sending young Mac aboard. In no time at all, you'll be in each other's arms. You're glad, I guess. Mighty glad.
Are you?
Me? What have I got to do with it? Oh, here's a little wedding present for you. $20,000. That'll set you and Mac up in a nice little home, all right. I'll never get a chance to do this again. Goodbye. All happiness to you. Where's Mike?
Well, he went below to call you.
Below?
Holy smoke, he's after Samson.
Help! Help!
What you doing?
Let me go, Captain Bill. That man belongs to me. I'm gonna kill him for what he do to my Anana. I'm gonna break and twist every bone in his body.
Nothing suits me better, Mike, but that's one pleasure I can't give you. There's a rope waiting for that guy in Tapillo.
Rope is too good for him. He should die as my Anana died.
I know, Mike, but we can't cheat ourselves. They've got £1,000 reward on his neck.
That won't make me forget.
I know how you feel, but... Come on, fuck up, old kid. Think of all the oceans we ain't even seen yet. There's a world of fun just waiting for you and me.
Ahoy!
Come on, kid.
Hello, Mac.
Bill!
We saw your distress signal. Something wrong?
Plenty that's wrong and lots that's right.
Hello, Mac.
Madge. Madge Lewis. Well, of all the... What are you doing aboard this
ship? Never mind what she's doing. Don't stand there gaping at the girl. Take her in your arms and give her a kiss. That's what she's been waiting for. We've been lying here at Quica waiting for you to get in so that you two could get married. I got a master certificate. I'll splice the knot and get it over with.
But, Bill, I've been married for the past 6 months. Madge knows that. She's not at all the time. She was the one that sent me away to marry the other girl.
What? Hey, why'd you let me carry you off the fine young man?
Well, I wanted to go for a sail.
Well,
Don't stand there gaping at her. Take her in your arms and give her a kiss. That's what she's waiting for.
You might...